दहेज के आठ पर उसे बेच दिया। मालिक का खौफ और कानून का डर, धन के लोभ ने सब भुला दिया। नन्ही बेटी को जीवन का वर दो।
जगत जननी है वो, प्रेम की शक्ति है वो, शीतल छाया है, परिवार की आत्मा है वो। मक्का के प्यारी को किसे याद नहीं, आंखों का छलकता सागर किसे याद नहीं, बेटी का लाड और पत्नी का।
गांव की सरपंच रही, कामयाब राष्ट्रपति प्रधानमंत्री रही, एस्ट्रोनॉट डॉक्टर, विज्ञान ने, भक्ति ने, साहित्य और कला में शोहरत है हासिल उसे हर क्षेत्र में। हत्या क्यों करते हैं गर्द ने उसकी, चीख अनसुनी क्यों करते हैं मासूम की। बदलो समाज की कुरीतियां मान्यताएं, बदलो। निर्भय भरोसा प्रभु का करो, उनकी नजरों में सच्चे इंसान तो बनो। जब एक है परमात्मा और आत्मा उसकी अंश है, तो भेद स्त्री और पुरुष में हमने क्यों किया है।
नन्ही बेटी को जीवन का वर दो, नन्ही बेटी को जीवन का वर दो, जीवन का वर दो।
Hey, don't you think it was an eye opener for all of us? Hope everyone got the important message that girls are as important and precious as boys. So let's celebrate.
afternoon, everybody. Respected Sister Tara, Father Stephen. This is Rupali Thakur and her family members. The distinguished guests, respected parents, and my dear children. I think it's a real proud moment for all of us, isn't it? I, as a parent, am feeling really proud and on top of the world today, as my son also studies in this school, and he was also one of the performers today. I have seen a change in this boy, school, and I compliment the principal and the staff for giving him whatever he is today. Well, dear parents, we saw a plethora of spectacular performance of these small children today. They took us around entire India. As we all know, our country is full of diversity, different cultures, different languages, and we got the real taste of it today through these small children. I compliment the school, the teachers who trained these small kids. I'm sure you all parents must be feeling really proud that you put your votes in one of the best schools in and around Seoul. As we all know, the school is pretty old now, long back, established in 1958. Apart from the education that it imparts on the children, it imparts a lot of other characteristics also, good discipline, good sports events. I also wanted to compliment your school and particularly Mr. Sahu for having celebration. If some of you were there that day, I compliment him and the school and the children who participated. Not only these performances, but this school is also imparting certain very important teachings. Today we saw how they presented the case of a girl child.
Without a girl, it's impossible. 4 days back, we were having a meeting here by the Directorate of Census, in which the detailed statistics about India, the state of Himachal, and in particular District Solon was being presented on different parameters. So there I found still we have disparity in the number of men and women in our society. Why should it be so? Why can't we be equal in number? The presentation was outstanding. They showed that women are no less than men in any field. In our country particularly, we have had President of India, we have had a dynamic Prime Minister, we have women in all aspects, all fields of life. Pilots and fighting the men shoulder to shoulder in the battles. So far they are not combatants, but they are very soon going to be combatants. So where is, why should we not give an equal place and equal status and rightful birth to a female child? Well, friends, all of us are to be blamed for this. So we should take a lesson from these small children, not only to our own selves, but to our neighbors and the society at large. Wonderful performance, ma'am. I must compliment the children and the teachers who taught them all these various aspects. And I gather that you celebrate all kinds of days that are celebrated in the world, Anti-Tobacco Day, World Women Day, all kinds of world. These are small things, but they give a lot of education and teaching to the small child. We all know this is the best age. I think today you have this performance till the 5th standard. So this is a formative year in a man's life or a person's life. Whatever you want to make out of the person can be motivated and molded at this particular age. As parents, why is it only the responsibility of the teachers? As parents, we also lack a lot. We need to teach our children very small things. The presentation, one of the, you know, the one act play, the court play was outstanding. outstanding, I must say. They gave so much of lesson in that small presentation, mind-boggling. A lot of meaning, you know. How we spoil our children, how we don't spare time for our children. I am also one of the, you know, not a good father that way, because I also have very little time for my family, maybe because of my commitments in the government job. But well, that is no excuse. The fact is that one of the boys was saying that his father, the moment his father comes home, it's so late that he sleeps even without having met him. And early morning, he is off to the school, father is still sleeping. You know, recently when the Honorable Prime Minister of a country was speaking to all the children in the schools, so one of the child asked him, how can I help the nation in its building, nation building? What should I do? How can I contribute? You know, his reply was that you go home and remove your clothes, put them nicely so that your mother gets time not to fold your clothes, but she has time for other works. Don't bother your father. Don't spill out things here and there. That is a great service to the nation. What else do we expect from a small child? What else? Small little things. If he does small little things, grows up into a nice man, nice girl, nice woman, and that is the great service to the nation. You know, what is national service? Am I doing a national service as a deputy commissioner? Which a man outside who's sweeping the road is not doing? Is it true? No, it is not. He is doing better service than what I may be doing. So therefore, what I always insist and practice and preach is that we must take pride in whatever work we do. That's a great national job. That's a great national service. Today, our country has reached Mars. Sir, proud today, proud to be Indian today. We are proud Indians. What great event has the scientist done? Just imagine, we are the first country in Asia with two giants like Japan and China around us. We left them far. Developed countries far behind. So is it not a proud moment for all of us? So why I'm saying this is, these small children who have performed so outstandingly well today, I'm sure they are the future of country. They will take this country much ahead from whatever it is today. It is in our society only that your son or daughter remains with you till the time he or she is married off. Maybe he or she becomes 30 years, still they are dependent on you. It is only they, when you grow old, who looks after you. I got an opportunity from the government of India to visit USA for about a year on a government training. In the universities, there were direct students, young students, boys, girls studying with us. So I asked one of the students, I said, you are a bloody foolish chap, because by the time you have just touched 12th standard, you say thank you very much. Why I am saying this is that there are different types of society. There are different type of privileges, perks, you know, good things, bad things about yourself. So that boy turns and tells me, look, it's not my fault. It's my society where I am living in today. If I live with my parents after my 12th standard, all my neighbors would say that he is a parasite on his parents even today also. So per force, they have to move out. But there is one thing good about this moving out. Well, they are no more dependent thereafter on their parents. They go work for short durations, earn money, and they do higher studies. They do work in the field. They sincerely go, they go all around the world. So what I'm trying to say by this is, our culture by far is the best. We are safe in the hands, our children are safe in our hands, and we are safe in their hands when we grow old. It's a great virtue, which is not there in the Western nations, Western world. So I will not like to take much of the time. So small little things, you know, we always say ki apne bachon ko ye namaste karein. They may look very foolish. Ke yaar itna ye DC saab kya ye yahan pe hamare ko samjha rahe hain, hum to bude ho gaye bachon ko bada kar karke. But there are basic things ki bachon ko namaste karna sikhaiye. उनको कहिए कि आप अपने माँ बाप के अलावा जो अपने गुरुजन की इज्जत कीजिए. यू गो टू स्कूल, मस्ट रिस्पेक्ट योर टीचर्स. Nirbhar Bharat Abhiyan was recently relaunched by the government of India in a large way. We had a video conference. First of all, the state had video conference at the national level, then we had it at the state level, teaching very small little things. How to keep ourselves clean, how to keep the environment around us clean. They may look very small things, but friends, when you move out, you see on the roads, you see here and there, lot of garbage, lot of things. In fact, I was yesterday out, today, because sister gave me a deadline that you have, jolly will be back. So I was on a very important assignment from the National Green Tribunal. A committee of four officers had been constituted to look into the pollution aspects of BBN area. So I had to leave that meeting today halfway and rush to the school to be present here amongst you. Well, I'm grateful that sister gave me this opportunity and talk to you and see such spectacular performance of the children. But you know why I'm bringing all these things to you is that everybody in the nation is concerned about the dirt and the spoiling of environment. We are all concerned. We are all educated people. How important the environment is for our health, for the upkeep of this nation, for the upkeep of... There are doctors sitting here, they always tell you, remain clean, aap saaf safai rakhe. So what I am trying to say is, these things look very small. They tell our children right from the word go. And the outstanding children that I saw today, they may not have to be told twice. Once you tell them, it will be sufficient. They will definitely understand what you have taught them. So in the end, I again say that we are all proud parents today, and I see that all of you, I'm sure leaving aside very important people who are just engrossed in their jobs elsewhere, but most of us are here today. It's a real proud moment for us. It's a real proud moment for this school. And sister, I thank you very much for having given me this opportunity.
Good evening, my dear friends. On behalf of St. Louis School, I warmly welcome Nuncio to India and Nepal. He is the ambassador of Vatican to our country and to Nepal. A warm welcome to you.
Just